Good morning everyone. So today again we will continue with the same topic of number system, that is irrational numbers. Till now whatever we have done is we have done about the identification of rational and irrational numbers, their decimal forms, converting decimals into P upon Q form. Now today we will talk about this operations on irrational numbers. That is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. How to add them, how to subtract them. Now just you have done it algebraic expressions that if there are like terms, for example, if you are given two terms, say 2x and 5x, you can add these two, 2x plus 5x, because they are like terms, you can add them making it 7x. Even if it is to be subtracted, 2x minus 5x, it becomes minus 3x. So here if you see 2x and 5x, the two terms which are there, they are like terms. So because they are like terms, so we can add them and we can subtract them. But if suppose you are given unlike terms, say it is 2x plus 5y or 2x minus 5y. Now here if it is there, because they are unlike terms, so we cannot add them nor we can subtract them. This itself will be the result as answer. So the same way we have to do it the irrational numbers. Now if you are given under root 2, and say you are given under root 8. If you have to add, now here it is under root 2, it is an irrational number. 8, again it is not a perfect square, so again under root 8, it is irrational. But what you can do is, under root 8, you can factorize it, and if you factorize 8, it is 2 multiply 2 multiply 2. Now here if you see, there is one pair of 2 formed here, 2 multiply 2. So under root 2 plus this 2, if you take it out, the square root, it becomes 2 under root 2. Now here in these two numbers, if you see the irrational part, here the irrational part is under root 2. In this also, if you see the irrational part is under root 2. So the irrational part is same. Whenever the irrational part is same, what we will do is we will add the rational part, that is 2 in this, and here it is taken as 1. So we are going to add these two. So 2 plus 1 gives us 3, and this irrational part will be kept as it is. So under root 2 plus under root 8, on simplifying it, we get 3 under root. Same way, if I give you say 2 under root 3 plus 3 under root 2 plus 5 under root 3. Now here there are 3 numbers to be added. And if you see, all the 3 are irrational numbers, because under root 3, under root 2, under root 3, they are irrational. So 2 under root 3 is irrational, 3 under root 2 is also irrational, and 5 under root 3 is also irrational. But out of these 3 numbers, if you see, only in the first number and the third number, the irrational part is same. They are equal. So when irrational part is equal, we will add the rational part, that is 2 and 5, because both are positive. So 2 plus 5 gives us 7 under root 3. You are not going to add under root 3 and under root 3. It will be kept as it is. And this under root 3 under root 2 will be kept as. So this is the final result of this. This is the sum of it. Here you cannot add it further because the irrational part is not same. Or in another way, what you can see is like 2 under root 3 and 5 under root 3. If you see there, under root 3 is common. If you take out under root 3 common, you are left with 2 plus 5. So 2 plus 5 gives us 7. So it is 7 under root 3. So this is how we add the irrational numbers. Same way is for subtraction. If suppose now you are given 7 under root 6 minus 2 under root 6. Here now the irrational part, that is under root 6 and under root 6 is equal. So the rational part will be subtracted. 7 minus 2, if you subtract, it gives you 5 under root 6. If the irrational part is different, you cannot subtract. Now for example, if suppose you are given 2 under root 5 minus 5 under root 15. Here 5 is having only one factor, that is say 5 itself, or one more is there, that is 1 and 5. But 15, the factors of 15 are 1, 3 and 5. Now here there is no pair of the factors form. 1 is alone, 3 is alone and 5 is also alone. So we cannot do anything, it will be kept as it is. Here now the irrational part is different, so we cannot subtract or solve anything. We will keep this itself as the result. This is the result itself. Now let us move to the multiplication part. In multiplication also, if I just compare it with the algebraic expressions, say you are given 2x multiplied by 3x, and on the other hand I give you say 5x multiplied by 2y. Now if I ask you what is the product of these two, now 2x multiplied by 3x, how do we multiply? We multiply the coefficients, that is the numerical part is multiplied. 2 multiplied 3 gives us 6, and we also multiply the variable part, that is x multiplied x, it gives us x squared. So product of these two is 6x squared. Now here 5x multiplied 2y, how these two be multiplied? Again the same, the numerical part will be multiplied, 5 into 2 gives us 10, and x and y, these also when multiplied you write it as xy. So the product of these two is 10xy. Same way the irrational numbers are multiplied. Now for example, if I give you 2 under root 3 multiplied by 3 under root 3, here again what you will do in multiplication, the rational parts will be multiplied, that is 2 will be multiplied by 3, that is 2 multiplied 3, and the irrational part is also to be multiplied. You will multiply these two also. So under root 3 multiply under root 3, it will become under root 3 multiply 3. You have to multiply the values in the under root. So 2 multiply 3 is 6, and here if you see there is one pair of 3 form, that is it will give you under root 9, and we have the under root of 9, square root of 9 is 3. So under root 3 multiply under root 3 will become 3, and what is the product? 18. We get our product as 18. If there are different values, means the irrational part is different, say you have 2 multiply 10, 2 under root 10 multiplied by 3 under root 15. Here what you will do? 2 and 3 will be multiplied, that is 2 multiply 3, then under root 10 multiply under root 15, it is 10 multiply 15. Now this 2 into 3 is 6. Now 10 multiply 15, what you can do is you factorize it. 10, the factor become 2 multiply multiply 5 and 15 the factors are 3 multiply 5. So here you have one pair of factors, that is 5 into 5. So this 5 into 5, this 5 can be taken out of the square root and it will be written as 6 multiply 5 under root. Now you are left with 2 and 3, that is 2 multiply 3. So the product becomes 30 under root 6. So product of 2 under root 10 and 3 under root 15 is 30 under root 6. Same way is the division also. If you have to divide again, it remains the same. Say you are given 8 under root 6 to be divided by 2 under root 3. Now here if you need to divide, division, as you know that we convert it into multiply and we write it as 2 under root 6 upon 2 under root 3. We can write it in the form of fraction. Here again the rational part will be simplified and the irrational part will be simplified. So 8 divided by 2, it can be simplified and you get 4 here. Now this under root 6 and under root 3, you can write it in a common under root, that is 6 upon 3. And when you write it as under root of 6 upon 3, this 3 and 6 can be simplified. And what do you have? You have the result as 4 under root 2. Let us have one more example. Say it is given as 12 under root 15 divided by, say it is 16 under root 10. Now here 12 and 16 will be cancelled out, simplified. It can be simplified on table of 4. It is 4 3s are 12 and 4 4s are 16. So you have 3 upon 4. Under root 15 upon under root 10 will be written as under root 15 upon 10. And 15 and 10, here again you can simplify it on the table of 5. 5 2s are 10 and 5 3s are 15. So what you have here? 3 upon 4 is this rational part. And in the irrational part, you have under root 3 upon 2. So this will be your result. And this result, if you want, you can write it in another form as 3 under root 3 upon 4 under root 2. So this is how you are going to multiply, subtract, add and divide the irrational number. Now based on this we have the next part, that is rationalizing the irrational numbers. Like if you are given an irrational number, we can rationalize it. Now what is the meaning of it and how it is done, that I will explain you. If suppose you are given under root 2, by what value can you multiply so that the product of these two becomes a rational number? Now you have to identify this value by which under root 2 is to be multiplied so that it becomes rational. Now when it will be rational? It will be rational if the square root sign is removed. And when will the square root of sign will be removed? If the value under it is a perfect square. Now in order to make this a perfect square, by what we should multiply? It is 2. If we multiply 2 by 2, 2 into 2 becomes 4, and 4 is a perfect square. So square root 2 will be multiplied by square root 2. If you multiply square root 2 and square root 2, it becomes square root of 4, and square root of 4 is equal to 2. So we multiply under root 2 by under root 2 to make it a rational number. Like if I suppose give you 3 under root 2, then by what number are you going to multiply to make it a rational number? Here again under root 2 is there. If we multiply under root 2 by under root 2, it becomes rational. How it will become rational? This 3 will be remaining as it is, and under root 2 multiply under root 2 becomes 2, and 3 multiply 2 is 6. So 6 is a rational number. Yes, here what you can do is, even 3 under root 2, if you multiply by 3 under root 2, the same value if you multiply, then also it becomes rational. How? 3 multiplied by 3 is 9. Under root 2 multiplied by under root 2 is 2. So 9 2s are 18. Again it is rational. But what we should do is, we should try to take the smallest value. More, if I say, if suppose it is 5 under root 18. Now by what value you will multiply 5 under root 18? Here you are not going to take it straight away, say 5 under root 18, or you take under root 18. No, that will just increase your calculation. What you will do is 18, you can factorize 18. So first try to factorize it and try to reduce it. So 18 becomes, the factors are 2 multiply 3 multiply 3, where 3 and 3 is one pair. This 3 can be taken out of the square root and it will be written as 5 multiply 3 under root 2, which becomes 15 under root 2. So this 5 under root 18 is equal to 15 under root 2. Now this 15 under root 2, by what you will multiply? You will multiply it by under root 2 now. And when you multiply it by under root 2, you get 15 multiply under root 2 into under root 2 is 2. So 15 into 2 becomes 30. So in this way you can rationalize it, just by multiplying it with under root 2. This was just a single term. Now let me take more examples. Where, if suppose you are given 2 plus under root 2. Now this value, by what you are going to multiply so that it becomes a rational number. Now it is 2 plus under root 2. Whenever such type of situation is there, or such type of irrational numbers you get, what you will do is, now this value, if you see here, it is in the form a plus b. There is a sign of plus in between. 2 you can take it as a, and under root 2 can be taken as b. So if you take it in this form a plus b and you multiply it with a minus b, that is, you will multiply this with 2 minus under root 2. These values will be kept as it is, only just you are changing the sign in between them. From plus it will become minus. Now if you do it, what is the product of a plus b and a minus b? It is a squared minus b squared. So same way, the product of these two will be a squared, that is square of 2 minus square of under root 2. Now square of 2 is 4, and square of under root 2, square of under root 2 means under root 2 multiplied by under root 2, that is under root 4, and under root 4 is 2. So square of under root 2 is 2, and 4 minus 2 is 2. So this is the rational number. So hence, if 2 plus under root 2 is there, we need to multiply it with 2 minus under root 2 so that we get a rational number as result. Let me have one more example. Say you are given 2 plus 3 under root 5. Now this number will be multiplied by 2 minus 3 under root 5. There was a plus sign in between, so what we did, we just converted into minus and we are multiplying it. Now if we multiply these two, again you are going to use the same identity, that is a plus b multiply a minus b. Now when you multiply these two, it is a squared, that is square of 2 minus 3 under root 5 whole square. So this is a squared minus b squared. Now here square of 2 is 4. But what is square of 3 under root 5? Square of 3 will become 9 and square of under root 5 will be 5. So it is 4 minus 45. And when you take 4 minus 45, it is minus 41. So again, this minus 41 is a rational number. So this part, when we multiply a given rational number by another number, sorry, given irrational number by another irrational number, so that the product becomes rational. This process is known as rationalizing. It is rationalizing. So what is rationalizing? When we multiply an irrational number with another irrational number so that the product becomes rational. This process is known as rationalizing the number. Rationalizing means to convert the irrational into rational number. Now here, let me just take one more example of multiplication. It is not rationalizing, but just multiplication. If suppose you are having 3 under root 2 and you need to multiply it by say 4 under root 3. Now how will you multiply these two? Or let me take it as under root 2 plus 3. Now here if you see, they are not in the form of a plus b and a minus b. So here what we will do, we will multiply it step by step. First we will take this 3 and this 3 will be multiplied by under root 2 plus under root 3. Then we will take the second value, that is second part, plus under root 2. And this under root 2, when it is taken, this will again be multiplied by under root 2 plus under root 3. So here, when you multiply these two, 3 under root 2, when multiplied, it becomes 3 under root 2. 3 when multiplied by under root 3, it will give you 3 under root 3 plus under root 2, and when under root 2 are multiplied, when square root 2 and square root 2 is multiplied, we get square root of 4, that is, it is 2 plus square root of 2 when multiplied by square root of 3, when we multiply these two, it becomes square root of 6. Here if you see, there is no identical term, means this term has irrational part as under root 2, this term is having irrational part as under root 3, this is having the irrational part as under root 6, and this of course is a rational part only, this does not have any irrational part. So this is the final product. This will be kept as a result. So in this way you can just multiply the irrational numbers. So for today we are just closing up, ending up with this, the operations on irrational numbers, and one extra part was there, that was rationalizing a irrational number. So this is it. Have your own examples and practice, and then tomorrow we'll continue with the next part of it. So thank you, have a good day.